Welcome to Salt Lake City, where winter is following its usual pattern. There's plenty of snow on the Wasatch Front. And inside the Huntsman Center, there's lots of talent on another top-ranked team. Tonight, the number 4 Red Rocks of the University of Utah hosting the number 16 Beavers of Oregon State. It's the Meet of the Week presented by Pacific Premier Bank, and it's live on the Pac-12 Network. Hi, everybody. Jim Watson and Lisa Mao, and welcome to the University of Utah and the Huntsman Center for a matchup of top 20 teams. On paper, they look similar. But when you go to the top, well, that's where everything changes.
Right. Oregon State head coach Tanya Chaplin is truly the dean of the conference. She's been around for 27 seasons. Could not be a sharper contrast over at Utah with Carly Dockendorf in just her 5th meet. But she has Utah where they typically are, at the top of the nation.
And this meet is not just a matchup of top 20 teams or a conference meet. It goes a little bit deeper than that. In fact, it's an Olympic reunion. The Red Rocks featuring the silver medalist from Tokyo and Grace McCallum. She already has 5 event wins this season.
Yeah, Grace is so exceptional, obviously, but this year she's been so important to get back in the lineup, especially on bars. She was the Pac-12 champion in 2022. After missing 2 months last season, she came back and was the runner-up on the NCAA. She's reworked her bar routine a little bit. I love the way she connects release moves in a row, and she's moved to the anchor spot tonight on bars and on floor. So we'll see if she can reach perfection like she has on bars 3 times in her career.
Yeah, that rally from the injury to 2nd at the NCAAs, that shows a lot about her character. Beavs have their own Olympian. Jade Carey won the Olympic gold medal on the floor, but tonight, no floor in the program.
Right, you'll see her on beam, where she's been near perfect twice this season, and you'll see her on bars. They're saving her legs as she does double duty right now. She's doing NCAA competition, and she's also preparing to earn a spot on the U.S. national team for her 2nd Olympic appearance. It is a lot of gymnastics that she has to do, and I think she's really going to rein it in tonight. She's got almost too much energy. The last couple meets has had some hops and steps, and we'll see if she can get the landings today.
Utah has dominated this series over the years, but last season in Corvallis, the Beavs flipped the script and upset the Red Rocks to earn a share of the Pac-12 title. Let's do it again. Number 4 Utah, number 16 Oregon State, the Meet of the Week, live and only on the Pac-12 Network. Call Salt Lake City crossroads up of the West, and certainly a lot of activity in this town, all the way from the slopes down to the temple and downtown. Last week we were here, it was in the high 20s. Tonight it's in the high 30s, and instead of snowing, it's raining. Remember, they met last year in Corvallis, packed house at Gill Coliseum. Utah was a top 5 team. Oregon State pulled the upset, 197.95 to 197.7. They clinched a share of the Pac-12 title. Utah lost twice last year. Both of them were close, and both were on the road. But in this building, it's been a different story. Oregon State has never won at the Huntsman Center. 36-0. And in fact, for the series, Utah has won 78 of the 90 meetings. Now, for Oregon State, they do have a veteran squad. They have 8 juniors and 4 seniors and grad students. So this is really a much different team than beat Utah last year. It should be a better team. It's more experienced. And of course, you got Jade Carey.
Right. That meet came down to Jade Carey versus Miley O'Keefe. Miley had the most uncharacteristic ball I've ever seen from her on her mount. Meanwhile, Jade does what Jade does on floor. I think she goes 9.975. It could have been a 10. To clinch that title, the Beaver Nation was going nuts at Gill Coliseum.
Miley O'Keefe against Jade Carey. There's your billboard right
there. Exactly. I think we'll get that today, hopefully, at some point.
Check out Utah on the vault as a team. They are only 3rd in the conference, 13th in the country, but 10-0 start values across the board.
And they have more depth than is in this lineup. They have worked really hard. Assistant coach Jimmy Pratt, he is a vault technician, and it is showing up. The improvement in these gymnasts from year to year is really exceptional, and I love seeing Emily Morgan anchor the lineup with her 1.5.
Winger has been in the lineup at every meet, her best, a 9.95 a couple of weeks ago to capture her first collegiate individual victory. Chance to set the tone early on for Red Rock Nation. Runway is clear, and here comes Cammie Winger.
Really nice entry, just a little bit flat off of the table, so didn't get quite the block for the perfect landing. The finish position is something I'm going to talk about tonight because the judges clarified it over the week. Gymnasts have to hold with their heels together and their arms above their head, or they get a half-tenth deduction. I think she went too fast there.
No college stick anymore.
No college stick anymore.
Oregon State ranks 16th in the country, but on the bars, second best in the conference, and number 5 in the nation. Carly Beamon leading off. Only the second time she's been on bars this year, but she's been in this lineup many times before.
Yep, she's very used to the lineup spot, but caught that Pike Yeager very close, had to bend her arms and her legs. She's a taller athlete, has a beautiful extension through her toe point. I love her stalter here. Nice straight arms into the double tuck. And gets the landing. You see how she held for that extra second? I would not take the deduction there, but, you know, not the most perfect start for them with the error on that release move.
9.825 for Winger, so it's a good score, not a great score to start it off. And Utah, interestingly enough, starts with two freshmen at the top of the lineup. Ella Zerbis next, the freshman from Stillwater, Minnesota, has been in the vault lineup in every meet. 9.875 against Arizona State, her best.
And her arms bent on the table, so didn't get the biggest block. That step off to the side there could be as much as 3/10. They just look a little tight right now. They had great warm-ups, but if you check out, her arms bent, didn't get the best repulsion, also had a little bit of knee bend before she got to the floor. So that step off to the side, hopefully that'll be the vault that they get to drop.
You know, because in college gymnastics, so much of it depends on the scores and the qualifying score that the team puts up. The win-loss isn't such a big deal, but you wonder if Utah remembers last year. I'm sure they do. Not the two freshmen, of course, but the upperclassmen, and if they've been kind of waiting for it. We saw this with Arizona State last week here. Same thing, Arizona State had upset Utah last year down in the desert, and Utah was ready. They were dialed in for it. They claim they weren't thinking about it, but how could you not?
Well, a team like Utah that has won this conference since they've been here, I can't remember exactly how many times they've won, but it's almost all of them, and so you always want to take down the top.
Natalie Briones, the junior from Gilbert, Arizona, next up on the bars, had a 9.9 at the Super 16 to start the season.
I've been really impressed with Natalie Briones' improvement over the last year. Just on the little things, like going for the handstand on that pirouette, I think she was within 10 degrees of vertical, certainly was in that handstand. See if she can dial in the stick on her double layout. Just the slide back, but beautiful. She has the most counting routines of any Beaver so far this season, has gone now 12 for 12, been super consistent.
And she is part of that freshman class from a couple years ago. It's a huge class for them. They had 8 freshmen on the team. Now they're all juniors. And Natalie has hit career highs on all 3 of her events this year, so maturing right on schedule. Two modest scores for Utah to start the rotation. And here comes Ashley Glenn, a sophomore. So freshman, sophomore. And Glenn, a transfer from Temple, has got 9.925.
And she's a dynamite vaulter. Really exceptional entry. Great block. Too much power there. Coaches would much prefer you step forward on that landing. Last week, she stuck it, but she landed on the line. So she was a little bit off to the side. What I appreciate about today is that she was a little bit on the left side, but definitely a dynamic vaulter. She has gymnastics pedigree. Both of her parents were gymnasts at Temple.
Hey, Tom and Glenn. Yep.
And she competed all around for Temple. The depth here at Utah, yep, though, they really needed her on that vault. Lost 6 athletes from last season. Did a good job to get that vault lineup back on track.
So a bit of an opening here for Oregon State early on. They get to start on their strongest event statistically. And Utah has come out of the gate flat-footed. So 9.85.
Next up on bars for Oregon State.
That's the biggest score we've seen in the meet so far. And Taylor DeVries now, freshman, 4 times this year, and every one of them has been 9.8 or better. 9.9 at the Super 16.
And Taylor is a little far out on that Pax Holto, so had to bend her knees and touched the ground. Could be as much as 3/10. I was about to say, her bars pedigree is exceptional. Competed for Legacy Elite. club known for their exceptional bars. So, you know, I think you jinxed her there a little bit. Not Taylor's best routine at all.
So nerves on both sides, and a missed opportunity there for Oregon State, but we're only midway through the rotation. Glenn comes through with a 9.875, so she continues to convert for them. One of her top scores of the season already. And here's McKenna Smith, first team All-American on this event last year, currently ranked seventh in the country with two wins.
Yes, she nailed this last week.
Oh, yes.
Exceptional Amelia Anchik ball, that forward landing. She is really exceptional at dialing in those landings. The look of that vault is a little bit more intricate when she does the half turn entry and then the pike front, exceptional form, just that tiny hop forward, but by far the best vault so far in the lineup. McKenna Smith is a vibe. You will see her dancing. She is really lighthearted.
There she is, right on cue.
Yep, she's really, Coach Dockendorf said she's really coming into her own this year and embracing herself, being herself on the team.
DeVries, a 9.7. And remember, you're gonna drop your low score and keep the other five. Jennifer McMillan, specialist on the bars. Four times she's got 9.8, including a 9.95 at the Super 16 in Vegas.
I really like her open swing. She has nice open shoulders on that bail to handstand. Very clean athlete, a little bit of an arch in the back on that handstand. Here's her double layout. Nails the landing. That arm waver forward is a deduction, but she did not move her feet.
This is her best event. She'll also be in the beam lineup. She's in the three spot right now. Take a look back at the dismount.
Yep, and she kind of does the open pike version of this double layout. So the first one's open and then pikes that down. You really want to keep the body fully stretched the whole time, but judges are going to remember that she did not move her feet at the end. Really important morale booster, I think, for this bar lineup. It's been a little shaky thus far.
Scores have been getting a bit better on the Utah ledger. Remember that Winger started with a 9.825, then Zervis with a 9.775. Glenn went 9.875. And we think McKenna Smith, once they punch it in, I'm not gonna give it to you officially. They have it up on the board inside the arena. The judges look like they're done calculating.
Yeah, there's a lot of movement up here at the operations table. Not sure if that has anything to do with Jaden, but you know, team captain had a really rough meet last week. She nearly fell on vault, she fell on floor. She came back to the gym this week and said, that's not acceptable for a team captain and a senior. So Carly said she worked exceptionally hard and feels really good about where she is today. Really important spot for her in this vault lineup.
Yeah, it was not a good vault last week. Considering that she was the NCAA champion on this event 2 years ago, you expect a little more here.
She got her arms to the table, made all the difference.
Alicia, you said it. It bothered her all week, and she was going to miss this opportunity.
What a delivery.
What's wrong with it?
There's nothing wrong with it. The execution there was so good, although I need to see in the replay, does it look like she has a tiny hop after she holds? She moved the left foot, so I see a 9.95 from one, I see a 10 from the other, who must not have seen that small hop, so she'll get them back on track, though. That 9.975, well-deserved.
That is a micro mistake. Almost perfect, one judge said she was, so that is a great score. And I love that the crowd reacted to it in a positive way instead of being disappointed in the second judge's score. Celebrate the 9.975.
Yep, and it looks like we saw a glimpse of Jaylene Gilstrap there at the end of the runway instead of Emily Morgan. So we'll take a look and see if that change is indeed happening.
Meantime, Jay Mack goes 9-8-5 for Oregon State. And here comes Sage Thompson. And this has to be kind of a strange experience for her, but a Utah transfer.
Yeah, you heard that ovation, though. This crowd gave her such a wonderful welcome.
Once a Red Rock, always a Red Rock, huh?
And a Utah product. She's beautiful on this event. She's gone 10. Very clean thus far. Good handstand positions. We'll close with the double layout. One step. This finish position change is really stumping these gymnasts so far.
I think it's a positive for college because we always used to kind of mock that college stick where they rolled out of it on their heels or their toes.
Yep.
And now they got to hold on to it and shoot. So there's Rucker, the partial perfect. One judge 10, one judge 995, so 9975 on the average. Jaylene Gilstrap in the anchor spot. So, of course, they want to drop the 9.775. That's what she has to get above, but she's looking for more than that, of course.
Yep, and she'll do just a Yurchenko full here. So 9.95 is
start
the
value.
Ceiling for her on this vault. She warmed it up well.
Jimmy Pratt, Carly Dockendorf went over and told her, we don't need a huge vault. We need a clean vault with a big score.
Yeah. She delivered both of them. Yep. That was both huge and clean.
It's that sweet spot, right? You don't want too much energy, too much speed, too much rotation. You can't go into it. You got to find that place where you're going to land clean.
Yep. Nice in the air. She's known for her technique and that form. So her feet are apart there on the landing. That's okay. She has to pull her heels together, like in first position in ballet. And then once she pulls her heels together and puts her arms up, that's when the judges start counting their 1,001 to not incur that finish position deduction.
3.985s now on the score sheet for Oregon State. Here is the Olympic gold medalist from the floor. Now on bars, Jade Carey.
Get ready, Jade's gonna do three releases between the bars right away in this routine. A little shy on that first handstand. And here's her full twisting pack salto, Bahardwaj, and one more here. Van Leeuwen between the bars, a little bit of a leg separation. And her full out is just textbook. And again, a little hop back. Coach Chaplin said where she's not struggling, but what's different for Jade, we're used to seeing her stick everything, is she's working skills that are much, much more difficult. And so to rein it in is something that she's really trying to work on today.
Well, and of course, when you've won an Olympic gold medal, people expect perfection every time out. It's like going to Emerald's house and getting chicken fingers.
Right.
That's it? That's all you got? It's sometimes unfair. Utah just went well over 49. Hi, we'll tell you women's gymnastics, the meet of the week presented by Pacific Premier Bank. Here's the numbers for Utah, who just put up a season best, and they did it by a lot. They had gone 49-4 a couple of times. They went 49-5-2-5. They end up dropping the 9.775 because Gilstrap went 9.925 on what was a simple but a very clean vault, great execution. But look in the middle of it, and Smith goes 9.925, and then Rucker steps up and was almost perfect. And you talked about it, she'd been aiming for this since last week's disappointment.
Yeah, this vault she had massive trouble with last week. None tonight, perfect block, beautiful execution in the air. Holds, we think in the old days, she could have just turned right to the judges and it would have been a stick. But you have to hold for 1 second after you put your heels together. One judge thought it was enough. One judge gave her the 10. The other one took the slight deduction, 9.95, which is what it should have been.
Elisa, my favorite part of that vault was her face after she landed and knew what she had done. Because look, you gotta challenge yourself in gymnastics, and she's been at the top of the table. She's been an NCAA champion on that event. But that was this week's challenge, to put last week's fall behind, come back and stick it, and she did. So it was a satisfying personal moment for her.
Yeah, it was a face of redemption. That was a face of, I know I can do this. I need to do this for my team as a captain, and she did. It was fantastic.
It took me 45 seconds to say what you said in 7 seconds, so I'll just defer to you from here out. That's all right. All right, so they're gonna trade sides, and Utah goes to the bars, where they're ranked 10th in the country, and Oregon State to the vault. They're number 17. They have a couple of gymnasts ranked here. Carey is 24th. Esposito is 33rd.
And you'll notice their start value difference. They lose 0.2 head-to-head with the Utes, I guess 1.5. The Gilstrap's full at the end there. So really important for them to get their landings dialed in. Esposito, the freshman, has been phenomenal on vault. Excited to see her towards the end of the lineup.
I've asked this before. Is it better to do a 9.95 start value vault that you're comfortable with and you can stick, or go for a 10 and risk having trouble?
I think coaches are going to give you a different answer depending on when it is in the season. Again, Natalie Bronis has had such a fantastic season, been so consistent. That was a very clean Yurchenko full. Lacked a little bit of the amplitude that we saw from Jaylene Gilstrap. That was the last vault that the judges saw to compare with for Natalie. So I see that in the 9.8 range for that Yurchenko.
Kenna Smith went 9.925 to start the meet on vault. Three times, she's gone 9.85 or better on this event, including last week's season high, a 9.875 against the Gym Devils of Arizona State.
She starts with a floaty pack salto down to the low bar. Beautifully done. Nice Van Leeuwen release move between the bars. Nice job keeping the legs together. This is a new dismount for her this year. A front pike with a half and just a hop back.
That's it.
Yep. She did the double Arabian last year, also very hard to land. The switch to this front pike, ostensibly, when you come over the top of this dismount, so she'll toe onto the bar, open up front half, you can see the floor the whole way down. That doesn't guarantee that you're going to stick it, but it makes it a little bit easier.
Carly Dockendorf, right side of your screen. First year head coach here at the University of Utah, but she's been on staff for 7 seasons now. 9.85, lead off for Briones, and now Garcia.
It's a powerful vaulter, full here, great distance, good
control.
She's got
3 straight vaults of 9.8 or better. She had been a lead off in this lineup before. They move her into the middle of it now. Had a 9.85 on this vault against Brown a couple weeks ago.
Yep. Nice straight body through the first 3 quarters.
Gets pretty deep on the table here.
Yeah, she's really deep on the board and the vault there. Does a good job not to let that impact her, but she does the 1.5. She's one where the risk reward decision comes into play for the vault staff here. She's been clean enough with that full that they're not risking the 1.5 yet.
9.875 for McKenna Smith. And ties her season high. Alani Sabato. And Utah did change its original lineup and put Sabato in. Sometimes it's good. Gymnasts don't have time to think about it too much. Just plug them into the lineup. She went 9.85 against Boise State. That's her season best on this event.
Very clean Jaeger to overshoot. Carly said it's about the fine details for her, the tiny execution things she needs to clean up, and the all-important landing.
There you go.
It's beautifully done, still has a hop, and I honestly think she turned to the judges too quickly. Could incur a half-tenth of deduction there. And both Carly and Tanya said, in practice, everyone's nailing the finish deduction. But in a meet, when you're so excited, you want to salute, celebrate, that is where they really need to hone in to avoid that half-tenth deduction.
Garcia, 9.825. That's 4 straight 9.8 or better. Here comes Sydney Gonzalez from Wildfire Gymnastics in Orange County.
A little too much there.
She's been, you know, since she was a freshman, she was in the starting lineup, so it seems like she's been there forever.
Yeah, there's been a Gonzalez at Oregon State
before that,
for
yeah,
quite a while. So she does this full-on pike back off. You're supposed to compete a full turn before you hit the table. And then the bounce in place, you can tell she had a ton of momentum, so that could be up to 2.5, 3/10 with the lack of control there on the landing.
Oregon State needs to keep contact with Utah early on again. They missed it at the top. Oregon State beat Utah last year in an upset to share the Pac-12 regular season title. It was a 4-way tie. But Oregon State has never beaten Utah inside the Huntsman Center. It's an intimidating building. It's loud, but I'll tell you, these fans are fair. If you're a visitor and you come in and you put up a good performance, they will cheer you. They understand what they're looking at. They've been doing this a long time. They've been selling out meets here and going well over 15,000 a meet for 30 years.
Love it. It's awesome for gymnastics.
I always tell people the first time I came to do a meet here, I came down the tunnel 90 minutes, 2 hours before the meet. I hear the crowd roaring, and I thought, oh my goodness, that nightmare that all announcers have. I'm late for the show. I run down, and a guard looks at me and goes, what's your hurry? I said, did we start? He says, no, they come for warm-ups here. I had no idea.
Fantastic.
9775 for Sabido.
Next up, applause for Utah,
Emily Morgan.
Emily does the same three release moves we saw from Jade Carey in the exact same order.
We heard from Emily coming back from break, talking about her prep for the upcoming Olympic Games would be her second.
For Maloney Bahardwaj, caught that a little bit at an awkward angle, but maintains form. Same thing that Van Leeuwen just wasn't quite all complete. And then here's the really unique entry that she takes to that dismount. She does the sculter into the front tuck half, nails the landing.
So I could be a 10. She's gone as high as 9.95 at the best of Utah meet.
Yep. So we saw McKenna do that with her toes on. Instead, she does it in a stalter position. Does the front tuck half out. At the Olympics, she did that out of the toe on front pike half. So she's done many different versions of that, showing her versatility.
It's more impressive in slow motion because you see her torque her body against her own momentum. 9.875. Great rotation going on for Oregon State right now. 9.85, 9.825, 9.875, and here comes the freshman, Olivia Buckner.
Excellent stick. She fell the last two meets in a row. I didn't want to jinx her, so to see her get that landing, I asked Tanya, do you keep her in the lineup? What does it look like? And she said her week of practice looked fantastic. We have nothing but confidence in her because it's all about continuing to believe in her and continuing to get the numbers for her confidence to rise. Really great job for the freshmen.
You know, I heard a coach years ago say, freshmen don't show up with confidence. They have to borrow it from the coaching staff that first year. And so the fact they stayed with her, and like you, I stayed away from past performance, is going to be a career best vault for her. Really? Emily Morgan, 9.875. So they can drop Sabato's score, but Zerbis, Keefe, and McCallum must come through for Utah. And right now, Utah is on pace for a 198. Still early in the meet.
She will start with a massive ray. Oh, and it's just a little too far. Waited a hair too long to release the bar. So, you know, she was stretched out as far as she could to try to catch that. So she normally connects that right to this pack and catches the pack close. So it's gonna have to dig out from that. Nicely done. She has 10-0 potential though. The lines, the difficulty, it will come for this freshman. See the disappointment on her face, but the sky is so high for her. I have no doubt she'll get back on track.
Well, she was coming off back-to-back 9.875s in her last two meets on that. I think she was really going for it that time.
Yep.
9.95 for Buckner. You said it was good. I didn't know it was that good. Wow. And now they close with Thompson and Esposito, both 9.95 start values.
Sage Thompson.
And every moment in this building for Sage Thompson is a battle of emotions and nostalgia. Just got to focus on that table.
And again,
chest down, and yet couldn't.
Trying too hard there, trying too hard for the stick, for that hero moment in front of this, you know, home Utah crowd for her. See what happened there. Yep, she's a little bit high on the table, so didn't get the huge block, but great distance. Unfortunately, has to both waver those arms and take the hop forward.
She's gone over 9.8 three times this year. This will be right about that number, and you can see trying to fight through it, had to take the hop. They had a little room to play with there, but then Sophia Esposito in the anchor spot will need to come through, and she is a rookie. There are two Red Rocks that are ranked on this event, and here they come. Miley O'Keefe, who sits 24th in the country right now, but O'Keefe's capable of anything at any time. 9925, she's done it twice. Double Arabian dismount.
Yep, it's all about, I mean, doing what she normally does, which is execute this near flawlessly.
I love watching her go about her business. She's just in her element when she's in this building.
Yep, she takes her time, performs her prep like the pro she is. Like the extension on that Maloney, really stretched to get the bar, and is a little under on that pirouette. That entire sequence was improvised there. Normally she does a half pirouette. Did the toe on half instead, missed the handstand there, so it'll be a deduction. And so will that little hop. So an excellent job covering up for that error.
And again, she's in that same class with a Jade Carey and a Grace McCallum. They're going to be graded on a different scale.
Yep. So not her absolute best, but if you know, the judges judge what they see in front of them, not what they think she should have done based on past routines.
Why is a freshman in the anchor spot for Oregon State? Because she's really good. She's won twice, has gone 9-8 or better on all four of her vaults, including 9-9 twice, and they need this score.
She's a powerhouse. Competed a double twisting version of that in development. It was exceptional. It's just a very nice clean vault. A little bit of arm bending on the vault itself on this block. Let's take a look at that. Yep, didn't quite explode off the vault like we saw the last couple weeks. Yeah, she's gone 9-9 twice. She's stuck this many times. The sky is the limit as well for this freshman.
And even though just a freshman, she, before that one, and we'll wait to see her score, 9 of her 11 scores in college had been at least 9-8 to start her career. Bodes well for the future.
Yep, and they really need her in the lineup as she's taking over Jade Carey's spots on vault. She takes that anchor spot. She takes the anchor spot on floor from Jade Carey. As
judges over on bar still talking about the numbers on Miley O'Keefe.
Yeah, I've no doubt they're debating that toe on half pirouette that she did on the low bar. I don't quite understand what they're debating about it. You know, she covered it perfectly. The pirouette itself was not in handstand.
Well, we got three nods, so they all agree.
But
we'll find out what they said.
Yeah, she had the requirements that she needed to start from a 10. Carly Dockendorf getting the explanation there off camera from the meet referee. Carly talked about this being one of the new dimensions of being a head coach is managing the meet itself for her team. If anyone's prepared to wait, it's Grace McCallum. She's done this.
We talked to Carly last week during the meet, and I asked her, you know, and you've said before, she had 5 titles before she became a head coach. And I said, well, what's the biggest surprise? What's the toughest thing about being a head coach? And usually you hear things about the administrative and how many things pull you away from just coaching. And so she said the only thing she's given up is working out.
Of course. I mean, she's been here. She knows this program so well. She's had 4 different titles before she was the head coach. She's done it all. And, you know, she used to do a ton of the coaching in the gym. She used to do a ton of the practice planning. So that part of it was not new. So the judges gave Miley a 9-8 start value. I see Carly going over to inquire. So that's that low score, 9.575. Yep. So.
Well, you said she was improvising in the middle. Did she have to leave something out?
She did not leave something out. But
wow. And so Grace McCallum now has to come through with a big score. NCAA runner-up from last year, ranked number 9th currently. 9.85 or better on every bars routine this season.
And I love that connection she does now between the Stalter and the Van Leeuwen. Just takes out one of those cast handstands. So far has been absolutely flawless.
get it. She's on her heels.
Gets the landing.
She's kind of rocking.
She was rocking a little bit. We'll see if they could count 1,001. But Megan Marsden there, former head coach, she likes it.
Megan sitting with Liz Abel, the longtime SID here for the Red Rocks. Helped build this program. They're at every meet. I never would have thought that Utah would be looking to drop Miley O'Keefe's score on bars, but it happens. It's part of this sport. It's why collegiate gymnastics is different than elite and is different than Olympics.
Grace is talking to Coach Jimmy Pratt there, who's the bars coach, was also always the bars coach before as well. It's not a new thing for him. And really talking about that dismount position, I think.
And Carly was always the beam coach, and she continues in that role as well.
Yeah, huge 995.
995 for Grace McCallum. So they will erase O'Keefe's score, keep the 9775 by Sabido. Halfway through, and Utah sitting on a 97-650, but Oregon State has gone in. Oregon State goes 49-350 as they end up dropping Thompson's 9.75. That ties a season high on vault for Oregon State, who already came in as a top 20 team on that event. And the top scorer came from the freshman right in the middle of the lineup, Olivia Buckner. Tanya Chaplin joins us now. Tanya, just go 49-350. What'd you think of your vault rotation?
Yeah, they did a great job. You know, holding those finishes helps too. So, no, I was really proud of them.
Can you talk about Olivia's vault there? Such awesome redemption for her.
Right. She has, you know, really, really worked over this past week of really trying to find that landing, opening up her hips so it was right there. So it was great to see that that hard work paid off today with that stick.
You know, Tanya, a couple of years ago, you were freshman heavy. I think you had 8 or 9 freshmen on the roster at one time. The kids have grown up. Now they're juniors. How has that changed things? How have they all developed?
They're amazing. You know, we've had a lot of turnover this year, a lot of new faces in the lineups, and they've really stepped into those roles, and I'm really, really proud of them. They've worked hard. They're going after it, and it's their time to shine. So they're really embracing that opportunity that they have to step into some of those shoes that have been in the lineups in the past. So they have big shoes to fill, but they're trying to continue that legacy on through.
And the floor lineup has a nice mix of old and young with Sophia Esposito down there in the fifth spot. Can you talk about what we should expect from the floor set tonight?
Yeah, we're just, again, like everything, working on our landings and finishes and showing it off. And so, you know, they've been doing a great job this week. So hopefully we'll see what they've been practicing all week come through here on the floor today.
Tanya, you have to juggle so many things as a head coach, and a lot of it is psychological. Did you talk to Sage Thompson about coming back to the Huntsman Center and how to kind of compartmentalize it all?
Yeah, she's doing a great job. You know, I think the biggest thing is celebrating who she is as a person, enjoying, and she's happy and enjoying the gymnastics. And, you know, she had a great reception. The people were wonderful here at Utah. And so she just has embraced that moment and come through. You know, I'm sure it's emotional for her, but she's doing a great job.
Tanya, always great to see you. Congratulations on that season-tying 49-350 on the vault. Keep it going.
Great, thank you.
Tanya Chaplin, the all-time winningest coach in Oregon State history. She has won 382 meets. She has coached 555 meets as the Oregon State head coach.
Almost as many as you've done.
I think that was an age joke. Tight meet. So Utah peeled Miley O'Keefe's score on the bars, ended up getting another tenth, a 9.675. Because of that, they hold on to the lead. So the meet score, 98.675 for Utah, 98.525 for Oregon State. So a little jockeying back and forth. And everybody's shooting for mid-197s. The season high for Oregon State is a 197.575. They had it against Brown. And for Utah, 197.725 at the best of Utah. At this point in the season, You should be leaving behind anything lower than 197 and building towards 198. That's just kind of a benchmark score. But now things get interesting as Utah goes to the balance beam. A lot of teams would shy away from it. But Utah is the best in the conference and number three in the country on this event. And Carly Dockendorf, big reason why they came back and became, the last 2 years, the best team in the country on the toughest event in the sport.
It's a little bit ironic, too, because Carly, as a gymnast, was known for her power.
Bars,
she was the bars champion. Yeah. She got 10s on floor, didn't love the beam. And she is an exceptional beam coach, has really empowered them to own their skills and feel confident in what they're doing. She does a great job. Adjusting the composition. A lot of new composition this year. Emily Morgan has a different routine, a great mount. Miley O'Keefe does a different mount. She really just keeps these gymnasts interested and alive and gets them ready to perform.
Dockendorf, the Pac-12 uneven bars champion back in 2003, and you're right, multiple tens on floor. She had five of them.
She's the last Husky to get a 10 on floor. It's been quite the drought since she left.
Graduated from UW in 2006 with a degree in English.
So spent time on the track team, was a pole vaulter.
Yep. And then she, you know, when she was building her coaching resume, Seattle Pacific, and she was coaching soccer, she was coaching track and field. And of course, you knew she would come back to gymnastics at some point.
Yeah. Utah really lucky to have her in the position that they needed a coach immediately in this offseason, and she has stepped in phenomenally thus far.
0.150 lead for Utah halfway through, and now they come to their best event. Two ranked gymnasts here, Paulson at 4, Morgan at 27, but the average as a team of 49.3, and they've gone 49.55 on the balance beam this season. You know, this has been a bugaboo and a signature event, and the home folks know it. For years, when they went to the NCAAs, this was the event that kept them from an 11th national championship. Now it's their strength, and this team is built to win. Number four in the country right now, beat Arizona State to start the conference slate. Emily Morgan to lead off on beam. Coaches will tell you the two most important positions: lead off on beam, anchor on beam.
It's all about beam, isn't it? So she will do a round off back handspring mount, sort of like you do over on the vault. Of course, she'll want to land on her feet on the beam. So check out this round off onto the board, back handspring onto the beam, right into a beat jump. Great combination. Triple series all the way down the beam. Good correction, use that arm to settle a little bit of a shoulder dip she had. Nice extension. Really great blend of the difficult tumbling and also showing off the flexibility in the dance. Really looks comfortable up there, exactly what you want in your leadoff roll. A little bit of wonky arms, I would say, in that full turn, but no visible error. And here's her front gainer full off the side. Unfortunately, has to take that step forward. The only real noticeable error in that routine.
Oregon State in the Olympic order as a visiting team. And rotation three goes to the floor. The Beavs, fifth best in the conference, 30th in the country, but they're only averaging a 49. So it is time for them to step up on this event. Start putting up some bigger scores. Natalie Briones, three times, has gone 9-8 or better on the floor, 9-8-5 against Brown, her best.
Starts with some front tumbling. Nicely done. It's okay for that sting mat to be there. Those are easy to trip on, though, so nicely done to dance over it.
Yeah.
excellent extension and precision on those leaps. We'll close with a double pike. And a little bit forward on that landing, so you're allowed to step backwards out of that. So forward step will be a deduction. Other than that, a very clean, very solid start for the Beavers on floor.
This would be the rotation in which you would expect Utah to create separation. Their strongest event combined with Oregon State's weakest event. Oh, I love it. Everybody's got to have their thing.
Like I said, McKenna Smith is a vibe. she's always dancing, she's lighthearted, but she and Abby Brenner have started a podcast called Between the Banners, and it's a great listen. They did a really good podcast about the gymternet and the toxic social media.
I know all about the gymternet, yes.
It's a great listen.
So 9825 for Morgan, and here goes Smith on beam.
Solid candle mount. Her vibe this season is about the 70s. Here, Grease, and then her floor music is also 70s medley. Nice job continuing that connection.
Has gone 9875 twice on this routine.
Series. Excellent. Coaches tell you to get your eyes off the beam when you're competing, and you sometimes cheat and just lift your head. Her eyes are in the crowd at different times. Solid leap series. She's done with the hard stuff. She's got the full turn. I think there's a moonwalk coming up here. Signature peace sign.
And there's the U.
The U. She'll do a cartwheel gainer full dismount off the side here.
Been pretty good so far.
Been great.
Hold on. The double pump.
Held on. Will be a slight deduction, but otherwise, just excellent. She's super fun to watch on beam. Let's watch the hold on this dismount. So her shoulders are a little bit over her knees, so she pulls back, but then takes that extra pause to avoid the finish deduction.
It's funny, they're talking about the U she flashes after she's off too, and I saw them doing that in warm-ups as well. They're both having a laugh about it.
That's their attempt to hold that finish position.
Oh, that's a good idea. Yeah. Rihanna's goes 9725. Savannah Miller.
Lots of double flips here. And unfortunately, timing way off on that. So sits down. She just made her way back into the floor lineup. Last meet. Tough fall. Those double flips I talked about. Nice double tuck. They switched the order of her passes from last week. Moved that one that she fell on to the first pass. Important that you get those leaps all the way around. She wanted to do a half turn, then a full. And so, yeah, new composition for that floor routine. Last week she did three passes, This week she just did two. That was a new leap series at the end there, but let's take a look at this first pass. So just overcooked, way overcooked on that 1.5. So when you connect positions like, skills like that, it's all about your landing positions. And so when you're excited and you're amped for meet and you're too aggressive, you're gonna miss a connection like she did there. She was just way over rotated. Unfortunate fall for her.
9.85 from McKenna Smith. Exactly what you want to see on beam is the scores starting at a good number and continue to go up. Grace McCallum.
She always checks back there to make sure the beam's still there. I would too before that mount.
At a 9.875 against Boise State in their opener. But last week, just a 9.775 on this beam.
And we should have five total wolf turns here. We count them.
We go triple, then double.
We go a triple, then a double. Yep, she always does a fun little arm choreo between the two. I asked Carly about this. Ooh, you noticed her right foot barely made it on top of the beam. Great cover. She sees those as her signature. She does them beautifully. Here's her back handspring layout series last season, and before that, she did the side area of the layout, but was just more consistent with the back handspring layout as she was there. Teeny bobble is the only thing I've seen so far. And watch, she's gonna run forward off the end with the gainer full, nails it. Awesome, dynamic routine from start to finish. Okay, check out these wolf turns. This is something that I want you to try at home. And I mean, the leg strength and the control, the everything it takes to do that, so much harder than it looks. They are much maligned.
And like an Olympic silver medalist.
Yeah, exactly. Not everyone in the gymnastics world loves them, but you cannot complain about the way she does them.
Miller with the trouble on the opening tumbling pass, and so just a 9.050.
This is who you want. You've got the senior leadership here.
Yep. Yep, coming off the fall. You need to get the train back on the tracks, get a big score. She's only been on floor a couple of times.
Now they have so much depth here. Unfortunately, lost Ellie Weaver last week, so had to put Sydney in her place.
Yeah, no floor against Cal for Sydney. Last week, 9.825 against Brown earlier.
I really like the rise on that layout after the front full. Nice job. Needed to get that switch leap full all the way around. I would say it was about 3/4. Saves her double flip to the end here. We'll do a double pike. Beautifully landed. Needs another leap series to get the bonus. And finishes just a little before the music there. But really what Oregon State needed, she knows that. Really sort of releases the pressure from the team.
We've seen it before in meets. It can scuttle a team's chances if you have a fall and then you don't back it up immediately with a big score. And the scores continue to rise. 9.925 from McCallum. And here comes their best beamer until you get to Miley O'Keefe. Abby Paulson.
Yeah, she's also gone 10. Carly said she sometimes gets overlooked. But she's perfect. She has been perfect.
And the reason I make the joke is because she is ranked number 4. And because Miley O'Keefe actually had a fall this year, not ranked on beam yet. But a couple of 10s could help that later.
Yep. And this is that beat jump is new into this series.
Hold it.
Yep, lands the legs a little bit close together, so the tiny bobble there gets that extra 10th bonus by putting the beat jump in the front. That allowed them to change her dismount this year. Last year she did the aerial to 1.5 and wasn't quite as confident in it. And so you'll see a new gainer fall off the side for her today.
Almost perfect last week on this event against Arizona State, 9.975.
This is a vault song from Taylor Swift, from the vault, Timeless. You'll hear more Taylor Swift from her over on the floor. Excellent. Gainer fall.
She's just so
long enough. Yeah. Her command of beam, the mental command she has, is really impressive.
Well, and you said it. She sometimes gets overshadowed by Miley O'Keefe, but you're ranked number 4 in the country, and you're putting up 9.975 last week, 9.9 something this week. People are going to start noticing you.
Right.
You'll get your due.
Yep. You've got a potential 10 in the 4 spot in your lineup. That's a pretty good beam set to have.
So while Tanya Chaplin is talking with Young, the judges once again gather, circling the wagons to go over it. I appreciate that they're trying to get every tenth, every point, make sure everybody gets the credit they deserve.
Yeah,
but it does throw off the rhythm of the meet for the gymnast.
Right. Ariana Young here, another senior, so she's experienced. If I had to guess, those judges were conferencing about that last leap pass. Her split ring half there wasn't quite at head height. I always say that technically they want you to almost kick yourself in the head backwards.
Ariana Young has been in the floor lineup in every meet, has gone at least 9.8 in every meet, at a 9.925 against Brown.
And one judge did give the 10-0 star value from Sydney. All right, looks like they both did, excuse me, for a 9.85. You can see that there.
.9875 for Sydney Gonzalez, exactly what they needed just when they had to have it.
Really fun, upbeat routine.
I believe I used to have this on 8-track.
Beautiful double pike. Comes back with a double tuck. Sort of walks into that, has so much power, but takes a deduction for that little hop forward. Important leap there, nicely done. Camera Jake Carey on the corner there, cheering on Ari before her final pass. Front layout, front full, a little bit flat, but well landed. Nice and solid, a good ovation from this crowd. They know a good floor routine when they see one. I don't think it will quite reach her career high 9.925 that she got earlier this season, but it should be close.
Speaking of 9.925s, Abby Paulson just punched one in. And here comes Miley O'Keefe, who already has 2 perfect 10s this year, but had a fall in between, so she's not ranked, but definitely the best beamer in the country, the defending NCAA champion on beam.
Mounts and goes right into her leap series. Nicely done. She uses this Rihanna Lift Me Up epic song that I think is as dramatic and epic as her beam is. Very appropriate. Yeah! Excellent.
Yeah.
Excellent. We're up 22 there. In honor of Ty Jordan and Aaron Lowe, former Utah football players. Just like that, she'll be off the beam, back handspring, gainer full.
School record holder in perfect scores on the beam.
Yeah, just what a treat that we get to watch Miley O'Keefe again. So glad she took this fifth year. The team really needed her, really needed her leadership, and she continues to deliver on and off the floor.
She has 13 perfect tens in her career. One on bars, 12 on the balance beam. 12.
Owns the Utah record there for most tens. He's nearing the Utah all-time 10 record. That series, so hard to go two skills in a row. This dismount, let's watch her seal off the 10. Well deserved. It was impeccable.
Lucky number 13 on beam for the great Miley O'Keefe.
I can be a little bit hyperbolic sometimes, but that was well deserved.
Not to be ignored, Ariana Young just went 9-9 for Oregon State on floor, their top score. And here comes Sophia Esposito. So one day the freshman will tell her kids or grandkids, I had to go on floor right after Miley O'Keefe got a 10 at the Huntsman Center.
I can see 10s in Sophia's future at some point. She is a dynamic, super powerful athlete. The ease of that front tumbling unfortunately goes out of bounds. The judges raise the hand there for the 1/10 deduction. Split. Nicely done. Love that little backdrop jump. She'll close with the double pike. No back handspring needed for her, though. She goes right out of a round off. Well landed.
Sophia Esposito from Melville, New York, a 15-time regional champion, 10-time New York State champion, and now a freshman at Oregon State.
Yeah, really powerful on the leg events, but also is super dynamic on beam. We'll see her there.
Whenever O'Keefe gets a 10, it always looks strange on the score sheet. There's no decimal point, there's only two digits. It's just perfect.
I'm sure Carly would say strange would not be her adjective. So they shuffled around the lineup a bit, so Jaylene Gilstrap will close the lineup. She has 10 potential as well. Beautiful extension, hasn't reached it yet though.
Let's go!
Woo, has to grip the beam again before her single wolf turn, and then unfortunately, yeah, the setup there, she looked a little nervous. She's, yeah, by not repeating that, she's gonna be missing the start value that she needed for the full turn. That's the least of her concerns after the fall there. It's a layout step out series here. Last year she did 2 feet. This year they switched to the layout step out. Another of the changes from Carly Dockenbrook's beam team. Watch the second leap here, this ring jump she does. Nicely done. just has really great flexibility down to her feet. The top of her feet point harder and longer than most people. It's a really beautiful look. She wants to get off this beam quickly. Here's her backhand spring gainer, full dismount. The fall, it was beautiful. It's an exceptionally high scoring routine. When she hits it, I have no doubt she will. So here's this wolf turn, looking up close just to see what happens. Yep, her leg just hit the side of the beam. It wasn't quite up as high. It's, again, I say that is, it is so hard.
But you're trying to catch.
Do that. You're trying to
the edge of the beam,
catch
right?
on the edge to help yourself. Stop yourself. So it's really the precision required is really difficult.
Meantime, Oregon State trying to rally on floor. Needs a number from Caitlin Garcia. 975 for Esposito. Remember, she stepped out on the first tumbling pass. That would have been well over 9-8.
And they made a last minute change. They were going to have Carly Chavez, but they went to Caitlin Garcia, who is fantastic on this event. She'll do the same pass that Savannah Miller fell on. No trouble. Nice and smooth. She just does two passes, so these leaps are very important. Very precise. Simone Biles-esque handspring seat drop there. Closes with a double tuck. Oh, unfortunately opened up too early. She was so high.
Yeah.
So high, really just truly opened up too early. She had it, so super unfortunate that Oregon State's gonna have to count a fall on floor. Really did not expect that.
Next up, an exhibition on green.
So a chance for Oregon State to rally and they just miss it. Meantime, Miley O'Keefe enjoying the treats of another 10. She deserved it. Even your 13th tastes as sweet as the first, doesn't it? 49.525 for Utah on beam.
Yeah, I thought about going back, but ultimately, like, school comes first and mental health comes first. And I know it's like a lot to take on. And I love college so much. I don't think I could ever leave that. But I'm really cheering for those girls and their training and competition season. So I've changed my routine a couple times this year. So I just kind of am trying to work out all those little kinks and just kind of gain that confidence in my beam routine again. His training's been going great, but I just need to piece it all together in competition.
Yeah, we hear gymnasts, we hear all Olympic athletes talking about the pressure building up, and you get that one shot at the Olympic Games, and it's not 4 years, it's a lifetime, because they started gymnastics 3, 4, 5 years old, and they're in a gym 4 or 5 nights a week. They grow up in that gym, and so to get to those Olympics, all of that pressure, I don't know that the average sports fan, and certainly a lot of Olympic fans are neophytes to gymnastics, that's the only time they see it, I don't think they quite understand what goes into it.
Right, and the teams are so small. They get 5 athletes.
Your whole country, your teammates, everybody you've ever known, your gym, your family, everybody waiting for you on that. It's not your body of work, it's that one day, that one meet at the Olympic Games, mm-hmm. and it can define you.
Yeah, and the talent pool for the U.S. Olympic team is so deep. You've got 3 reigning Olympic champions, Suni Lee, Gabby right. Douglas, and Simone Biles, all vying for spots. It's a really deep, really competitive pool. Emily Morgan said, you know, Great Britain doesn't have the depth, and so it's, you know, potentially a spot for her, and she's still got the zeal for it. She's still really excited about it.
Miley O'Keefe joins her teammates in the circle, but she stands out wherever she is in this building, as she just went perfect again on the balance beam. That is her 13th perfect score on beam in her career, the third of the season, and her 14th of her career, adding in the one on bars.
And it's one of the most difficult flight series being done in the NCAA. She does it flawlessly as she does that dismount, and she knew. She knew right away that she did it. Yeah,
and she knew she deserved it.
Yep, and it's because her technical precision is incomparable. Her basics are so good, and when she nails it, it should be perfect, and it was.
I'll tell you what I like about the new scoring in college and holding the landings longer. There are fewer 10s now, and for a while, 10s were getting watered down. It should be a special thing. You should not see one every meet, but if you have Miley O'Keefe, it's always on the table, isn't it?
I would say there are fewer in the Pac-12. They still fly a little bit in some of the other conferences.
Watch your head on the boom mic. Thank you. Yeah. Is that McCallum that reached up, pushed that thing out of the way? I was getting worried because they were hopping.
That's a school mic.
Yeah, not us.
Not a TV mic, but regardless, no one wants to get bopped in the head before they go on the floor.
Yeah, not only is it one of the best teams in the country and one of the all-time great programs, but they promote the heck out of this gymnastics team called the Red Rocks here at the University of Utah. And all you got to do is look up from the floor and see just about every seat in the lower bowl is filled, and about half of them in the upper bowl. They're looking at another crowd of 13, 14,000 people inside the Huntsman Center. They had an all-time record here of over 16,000 a few years ago against Michigan. And every time I walk in here, I just marvel at it. And I'm glad that I could be just a little part of it. It is a lot of fun coming here to the Huntsman Center. They know their gymnastics. And right now, Utah with a 148.2. They only need a 49.1 for a season high. So it's the best night of the year so far for the Red Rocks. Jim Watson, Lisa Mao inside the Huntsman Center, where we have a matchup of top 20s, number 4 Utah, number 16 Oregon State, and Sunday, two more top 20 teams at Pauley Pavilion in Westwood. UCLA has moved up from 15th to 11th in 1 week as they come off a season best, taking on John Court and Arizona, sitting at number 18. I'll tell you what, that Arizona team, they are top heavy with juniors and seniors. They've done it before, road tested. That is a good team right now. Want to keep your eye on Arizona. Will be on the air at 2:00 with the Bruins and the Gymcats of the U of A here on the Pac-12 Network. There's a meet going on also down in Arizona right now. It is the Maroon Monsoon. I'm not sure what Jay Santos was thinking. I was teasing him when he was here last week. He comes in here against number 4 Utah. Then he goes home to meet number 1 Oklahoma and number 2 California. But listen, those are the meets that make you better, because you got to chase the best. You see where the level is. So when you run into them at regionals, you're not intimidated. You've seen them before. So that's the score after one rotation.
Yeah, it's so fun to see the 1-2 head-to-head. Cal has been so phenomenal. Still haven't hit a perfect meet yet. You know, like you said earlier, the win-loss record does not matter in gymnastics. It's based on scoring, but, you know, from a reputation, and it's just fun to say you're number 1 or to say you beat number 1.
Well, consider this. UCLA, when they were number 15 in the country, was 2-7 in record, because they were in a couple of quad meets where they had finished 3rd or 4th. It doesn't matter, because it comes down to the national qualifying score. And this is where I go inside baseball, and some of the folks sitting on the couch say, what are you talking about? But here's how it goes, and this is why gymnastics is the most fair in rankings. NQS, you take your top 6 scores of the season. 3 of them have to be on the road. Drop your high score, average out the remaining 5. That's your number, that's your ranking. You just put them in order. It's the computer. There's nobody involved in it.
Yep, and as teams get those 6 meets, I think a few teams have their 6 meets this weekend, but it takes a couple weeks for everyone to catch up.
Watch
the rankings get wonky.
Yeah.
Yep, and so I see Utah Utah staying up there in that, you know, fourth spot. They got to get real high 197s to compete with Cal and with Oklahoma. Oregon State, though, taking a deep breath collectively. They need to take a deep breath and get a big 49.5 here to make this a viable road score for them.
Yeah, the road score is, it's funny when you talk to coaches about the NQS, they always bring up the road score first because those are the toughest to get. Sophia Esposito lead off in the final rotation for Oregon State.
She has a 3 combo here coming up right off the top. 3 skill combo, lost that word for a second. She'll do a switch leap to a switch split jump to a back layout right now. 1, 2, and unfortunately missed the connection. Connects the beat jump though into the back layout. Super difficult, connect all 3. We saw her power on floor, see how she harnesses it on beam, that layout. Left shoulder just a little bit off there. You can tell it is an intimidating place for a freshman in your 5th meet. Double twist.
Beautiful.
Tiny hops back. It was huge. Say she was a little bit far from the end of the beam on that round off. Sort of
freshman.
Stuttered her steps. Yeah, I mean, a freshman in 3 lineups. Really.
Lead off on beam.
Yeah. Really great.
We go to the floor. Utah, first in the conference, 4th in the country on this event, averaging a 49.4. Kenna Smith, first up.
Taking us back to the 70s. With lots of front tumbling. Very clean, double full. Throwback there with the cat leap to wolf full up one leg. Don't see those every day. We haven't talked much about the 3rd assistant coach, Maya Hambrick, who's the floor coach, does some of the choreography, splits those duties with Carly. She did this routine. Nice. Rudy to layout, stretch jump just to show off her control of the tumbling. She's very intellectual, but also looks like she's having a really great time.
You know, Maya Hambrick is still new to Utah gymnastics, and when Miley O'Keefe was getting her 10, you could see Hambrick in the background looking over the crowd going, what in the world?
She's used to those big crowds. She competed at LSU.
Yeah,
herself.
Sure. Huge crowds in the SEC. Buckner on beam.
Yep, this freshman, tiny bobble on the full turn. She was thrust into a tough position last week, replacing her injured teammate, and she did really well last week, 9-8 so far. Just some tiny balance checks. It's her leap series. She'll do a stag with the head back there. Chaplin said she's really working on taking it just one skill at a time. You can see the deep breathing. She's a local product, was really excited to come home, compete in front of a family and friends, competed at Olympus Gymnastics, same as Sage Thompson. Here's her back handspring, 1.5 dismount, holds on for the stick. She started off a little bit tentative, but you watched her confidence grow as she went through that routine. Great job for the freshman.
Yeah, big moment for the young athlete, for the young gymnast from Riverton, Utah. She had a 9.95 earlier on vault. Smith goes 9.875. Here's Jaylene Gilstrap.
Could not be two different vibes from McKenna to Jaylene. This is a really cool cut from Pirates of the Caribbean. She's doing a lot of mock sword fighting, along with showing off her flexibility. Front layout to Rudy. First pass. Gorgeous height. Actually, that front foot slid back, had too much power via slight deduction. Circle moment for the senior. A bounding step out. So unfortunately, after the huge start with her 9.925 vault, she just had a few little missteps, the fall on beam, and then those steps on both of those. But what a just special artistic athlete to get to watch. Carly Dockendorf did the choreography there. Those two, a really special partnership on floor.
9.8 for Buckner. Jennifer McMillan, we saw in the opening rotation, 9.85 on bars.
And it doesn't look that hard, but how she mounts the beam, and most people do a somersault and straddle the beam, but she goes off to the side. It would be very easy to just fall off. I'm impressed by that. She moves into her flight series. A little bit of a different combo to see the front toss down to the swing down. It's a good way to avoid some landing errors using that swing down. Like the back leg just a little bit higher. She needs to connect two leaps here. It's a new connection for her this week. Slight bobble on the ring jump. She'll do a gainer full off the side. And just a small hop back. Not her perfect best, but very clean. Like I said, the Beavers just want to really hit six routines, get up in that 49.345 to try to salvage a low 197.
Tanya Chaplin kind of building for the future, starting out with three newbies on the beam lineup.
Yeah, they compete. They are competing 13 different athletes today. They have got a lot of depth, but it's a mix of youth.
Abby Paulson. Paulson had a 9.925 on beam.
She's been waiting for a Taylor Swift routine her whole college career. They needed to find a way to make it work.
Big first pass coming up.
Yeah, I love this front through to a 2.5. Important to hone in on the landing, as she does. Excellent. Are you ready for it? Front tumbling and right to the stag. Love that. Love seeing her enjoy that so much. It's just a joyful.
Look at her teammates.
Experience.
I think they liked it even more. And that, the crowd erupted. That was beautiful stuff. She was in control and on balance the entire way.
Yep. Great combination of the dance and the tumbling. There's so many different styles that you can have on floor. She's tended towards the more dramatic, the hard music. So it's fun to see her really enjoy that routine.
The 9.875 by McMillan, by far a career high for her. So good rotation here by Oregon State on beam. They're ranked fifth in the conference, but 18th in the country. This is a great event for the Pac-12 across the board.
Watch Ariana's releve work throughout this. She's up super high toe after this front aerial back tuck. Tries to cover up the leg, but watch, she starts that full turn up so high on toe, nobody else does that.
Crowd response, they know.
Yep. Here's a ringed jump. Covers the slight error with her arm into that beat jump. Quick routine. She'll do a front gainer full off the end here. Usually great at getting the landing. And does again. Really exceptional routine.
She's got 9.875 twice. You got to figure that's right there.
Yeah, these judges, I feel like that's going to go 9.9, 9.925. Combination, you know, of the leaps, the tumbling. She had that one leg lift after the series, but that was it.
Is this the ascending scores you want to see?
Exactly.
9.875, 9.9, 9.925, and then Jaden Rucker, of course, purged the past of a week ago, all the way back in that first rotation on vault with her 9.975, takes over the floor.
It's all about this first pass for Jaden. Half in, half out. Really important for a good entry. And again, that's exact error that she had last week. The takeoff position just wasn't where it needed to be on that round off back handspring. For the final pass. One and a half, front layout, easily done. So just an unfortunate repeat of that first pass. She doesn't know what's going on. She does a round off back handspring, just needs to be, yep, needs to set it up a little bit more, needs to be at a different angle out of that back handspring to really rise before she twists. She started that half turn right off the floor. You gotta get some more rise to get that thing completed. There must be a start value issue with Young's score there. 9.775 is far too low. I thought that wobble was the only deduction I saw. Another beautiful senior beam worker here in Sydney Gonzalez. There's her front-to-back series. She's so smooth, so reliable on this event.
Coming off her season best against Cal a week ago, 9.925.
She finesses this beam routine. And there's her gainer front full, holds the stick. Excellent job. She's been so solid for them and is a really important part of their lineup on her three events.
Still waiting on the score for Rucker. But they have three good scores in the book already. 9.875 for Smith, Gilstrap the 9.9, and Paulson the high water mark at 9.925. And still to come, Miley O'Keefe and Grace McCallum. McCallum, the only of the Red Rocks ranked in the top 20 nationally on this event, currently sitting at 18. But as a team, Utah is number four. And that'll put a smile on the head coach's face.
Yes.
She was the choreographer here when she first got to Utah. That was her thing, took over the beam. So O'Keefe and McCallum need to come through. Again, they needed a modest 49-1 for a season high.
You're 2021 NCAA champ on this event. She's won a national title in all events except for vault. Also, your reigning all-around title holder. Start with the double pike. Watch the precision. Of course, when I say that, she pops back that front leg, so that'll be deduction. Front layout, front full. Nicely done. Great ring position there. No questions to the credit. Sort of like Abby's routine, these two have, looks like they're really enjoying what they're doing. It's a tough offseason for this team. And they were so important to how phenomenal the team is doing after five meets.
It always looks to me like Miley O'Keefe is just having fun, is just performing, not competing when she's at Huntsman. She plays to the crowd, they love her, they expect it, they react to everything. And she's bigger than the moment. She always handles it.
And that is because she's an expert at her craft. She is so technically good. Her basics are so sound, great fundamentals, so she can go out and sell it.
So you go from the NCAA all-around champion, Miley O'Keefe, to the Olympic gold medalist, Jade Carey, and then we'll close with the Olympic silver medalist, Grace McCallum. That's how you make sure no one leaves early.
Absolutely. This is one of those events where Coach Chaplin said she's just had a little too much oomph. Needs to really focus one skill at a time here. She was experimenting with a few different combinations in warm-ups today, so we'll see what she goes with. A few little balance checks on both that front aerial and the straddle jump. Should do a back handspring layout series. switch leap, switch half, front leg a little bit lower than I want to see. Just like that, the routine's over, but she nails the landing. She's had a few hops on that the last couple weeks, like I said, because that gainer full is so easy for her. We can, her skill arsenal is so broad. It's a treat to get to watch her, even if she does have a few little errors.
Jade Carey finishes the meet for Oregon State, and now closing it out for Utah on the floor, Grace McCallum. They have a 48.775. They need a 49.1 for a season best team score. Obviously, they want to drop Rutgers 9.125, and here's the chance to do it. The only chance.
She's been over 9.9 three times this season. Kids are quite capable. Here's her full in to start. But does not step out of bounds. Good finishing on those leaps. That back dive, part of her floor choreo for as long as I can remember, club or elite. In college. Big front tumbling layout to the Rudy. Seemed to get, was a little bit flat out of the layout, but no problem getting the Rudy around. Really fun routine, great energy from Grace.
McCallum had a 9.95 on bars. She had a 9.925 on beam. And now we await her score on floor. In the meantime, I can tell you that Jade Carey on beam, 9.9 for Oregon State. Give you the final scores on the meet. We come back. For sure, Utah has set a season best. We'll check the number on Oregon State. We come back to the Huntsman Center on the meet of the week. Another big night in Salt Lake City for the Red Rocks of the U of U. Grace McCallum closes the meet on floor with a 9.9, pushing Utah to a 49.55 on floor, just under their season best. It adds up to a total of 197.750. That is the best meet of the year for the Red Rocks. But let's go back and look at Oregon State. There were moments, right? They only end up with a 196.1. But you look at some of the scores for Oregon State. 49.35 on vault in the second rotation. That's their best score of the year. So there are some bright spots. Some of the younger gymnasts came through for Tanya Chaplin tonight. But of course, the big highlight of the night, Miley O'Keefe on the beam.
And as she has been now 14 times in her career, Miley is perfect on the beam. Exclamation point with that perfect dismount. She knew it, the crowd knew it, we knew it. What a treat to witness perfection again from Miley O'Keefe. Oh, and then she finished with a 9.95 on floor. She can really do it all.
Three perfect tens already for Miley O'Keefe. So Miley, of course, wins the beam. She also won the floor with a 9.95. In fact, Utah swept all the individual awards. Jaden Rucker on the vault. Nice night for her to come back after the disappointment of last Friday night.
And can't forget to highlight our all-around winner, McKenna Smith, the sophomore. So consistent, really growing in her sophomore season and enjoying herself so much.
Yeah, she just tied a career high. 39.525, McKenna Smith on the all-around. So there's something to build on for Oregon State and for Utah. And I talked to Carly Dockendorf before the meet. She said, what we need is something deep in 197 over 5, and she got it tonight. 197.750, a season high for the Red Rocks of Utah. For Alan Brum, your producer, Tim Lay, your director, Elisa Mao, my partner, I'm Jim Watson, saying so long from the Huntsman Center, where number 4 Utah rolls. Light up the U.